an inspiring teacher can ignite the spark that turns a student into a scientist, into someone who wants to understand our world and find ways to improve it. It was in high school that I found chemistry. In Anja Haavisto's class at Munkkivuori High School, and especially in her evening club, Nitro, I learned about chemistry's role in the environment and in our everyday lives. In fact, high school was where I did my first chemistry research project. I analyzed the inorganic substances in a mushroom species using very classical reactions. I was still a young student, but I had already learned how fundamental chemistry is and seen its potential. Those experiences fueled an excitement that only grew when I went to university. I began to see more of how chemistry and chemical engineering are connected to living nature. They can provide solutions we need for sustainability and to create welfare in society. I'm no longer a young student, but I'm still excited by these possibilities. In fact, as an experienced professor of polymer technology, I'm even more excited. Between ongoing research and my industrial background and collaborations, I see how chemistry and chemical engineering are truly the keys to the three great transitions towards sustainability. Moving from fossil-based fuels and materials to bio-based ones, transforming from linear to circular systems, and building new materials using green electricity. Clean energy from sources like wind and solar power will enable production of hydrogen from water. That can be used to produce materials without relying on fossil sources. In the future, materials should and can be CO2 neutral or even sinks rather than emitting carbon dioxide. These three transitions are not just necessary. They are also already underway, and polymer science plays a vital role in those. Polymers are large molecules built from a combination of subunits called monomeric molecules. It's a bit like assembling Lego blocks together to form specific structures. Polymers are also an essential part of all living organisms. They are an important part of our technology, from materials used in everyday life to highly advanced functional materials, like in electronics or in medical uses, as examples. Because of their size and structure, polymers can provide a huge range of different functionalities. Life on Earth has produced an enormous diversity of polymers. So far, we chemists and engineers can manage only a fraction of the structures and functions that nature has. The potential is there. Biopolymers, which are one of my main areas of research, play a role in moving away from fossil feedstocks as well towards circular systems. Biopolymers are based on renewable feedstocks. They can be based on cellulose, lactic acids, or biofats and oils, just to mention some examples. At the end of their life cycle, they can be designed to biodegrade. Biodegradation can take place within the desired time frame or under specific conditions, such as in composting or out in nature. Biopolymers are also about health and welfare. In my lab, we have designed new polymer materials for medical and pharmaceutical uses. Since we can control how polymers degrade, surgical biomaterials can be designed to be safely resorbed in the human body. Bioactive medical polymers can release pharmaceutical agents or even help tissues regenerate and heal. Some of the biopolymers that we have recently researched and developed show antimicrobial properties. They are antibacterial, and some of them are even antiviral. In some ways, my research is like a polymer. It combines different components into a larger whole. With its own powerful properties, it helps to create the transitions we need. My work has always been highly interdisciplinary, crossing borders and bringing together people with complementary skills. This has been absolutely necessary in the research like of medical and pharmaceutical polymers. Over my career, I have been excited to work with excellent collaborators and passionate, talented students. Our discoveries have come from the hard work and diverse backgrounds of many researchers. But interdisciplinarity is more than just combining different research fields. The potential of polymers won't be realized by research alone. Our scientific work goes hand in hand with inventions and industrial innovations. For me, it is highly motivating to refine scientific discoveries to innovations, new technologies and products to improve our society and make our lives better. I see the same motivation in my colleagues and especially in young students and researchers. I'm grateful and honored to be appointed an Aalto Distinguished Professor. But I'm even more grateful for what Aalto offers, for the opportunity to carry out world-class research and teaching. I feel lucky that I get to coach students as they learn and to innovate with them, passing forward the spark that was ignited in me by an inspirational teacher years ago. Thank you.